Southern Nevada World War II veterans just returned from the war memorials in Washington, D.C.
The goal of the Honor Flight of Southern Nevada trip was to give these veterans, most in their 90s, a measure of closure for their war experiences. The government shutdown, though, threatened that entire trip.
The I-Team's Nathan Baca went along for the trip to Washington and shows us now what these veterans gained on what they're calling a trip of a lifetime.
Yes, as 8 News Now viewers donated the money to make this Honor Flight possible, we profiled the experiences of three local veterans. Each one of them came to the memorial hoping for answers of their own. Here are their stories.
A monument made of marble for men and women made of something a lot tougher. These Southern Nevada World War II veterans beat Nazi Germany, defeated the Japanese Empire, and kept the peace at home.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now they gather one last time to see a memorial they waited nearly their entire life to see built.
This is a once in a lifetime. You know, I'm 88 years old now. How much more have I got to go? And to see this, I would never have seen it without the honor flights.
Herb Cohen is a retired Coast Guardsman. On board the USS Cavalier, he helped run the invasion boats charging Japanese-occupied islands in the Pacific. His first experience in the war, a Pacific Ocean filled with bodies from islanders forced to commit suicide by Japanese soldiers. After the war, Herb always kept a smile on his face, but one sight at the war memorials got to him. It wasn't the World War II memorial, but the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. The wall bears the name of George Ulrich, killed in action in Vietnam.
He was a good young kid.
Ulrich was Herb's neighbor. When Herb returned home from World War II, he believed it would be the last war.
When I got out of World War II, I said, this should end. But unfortunately.
That name and all the others, a sad reminder that the wars went on and on and on. Catherine DuPont tracked casualties and supplies heading out to the Pacific while based in the San Francisco Bay Area. She and the other women of the Waves were pioneers, paving the way for all servicewomen. Joining Honor Flight gave Catherine the chance to meet the few World War II female veterans left.
I think it's very awe-inspiring. I really, really enjoyed seeing it, though, and I'm so proud of what they did with it.
Bill Knapp, now 91 years old, dropped into Nazi-occupied Germany in the early morning hours of D-Day. The paratrooper lived through the carnage of Hitler's ravaged Europe.
See, I'm happy and sad at the same time.
All of these veterans were once just teenagers themselves, caught in a whirlwind of worldwide destruction. Now, teenagers shake their hands.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Robert Scaringa.
But closure finally came on the way home for these vets. Children, friends, loved ones sent letters to the veterans. They read them on the plane back to Las Vegas.
We are proud of you and proud of your family. Thank you for your service.
Those letters, those words of solace and pride were just too much for some. And then a grateful city, Las Vegas, welcomed them home. Through tearful salutes, the realization finally hit these veterans that in the twilight of their years, they had all finally reached a peace the end of the war never truly gave.
As for Bill Knapp, we will show you a closer look at his quest for closure on 8 News Now at 6. Honor Flight of Southern Nevada is looking to send their second group of Las Vegas World War II veterans this April. 8 News Now viewers made this first trip possible through their donations. If you'd like to help send more veterans to the World War II Memorial, we have a link on how you can help. That's on 8newsnow.com.
My dad was a World War II vet, and you had to pry the information out of him. They mostly didn't want to talk about it.
Yeah, and just to hear their stories come out when they're at that memorial is just
heartwarming.
So special.
Great story. Thanks, Nathan.